MacOS High Sierra on an unsupported MacBook Pro from 2009. Let's go. The startup was pretty quick. I wrote on Twitter that since upgrading this Mac to High Sierra, it started taking a bit longer to start up, but actually now it takes about the same as Sierra that I had before. It takes a while to log in, but here's the first issue I found. For some reason, it got rid of a lot of applications that started up automatically when I logged in. The applications are all still there, but they're not starting up automatically anymore. Thankfully, there's an easy way to fix it in the system preferences. You go to users and groups and login items. And here you enable all the applications you had before. The only ones I really need are window tidy and simple floating clock, which is this tiny little clock in the corner here. And also Dropbox, Music Manager, and Endurance weren't starting up automatically anymore. I didn't add them here, I just launched them manually and they added themselves here again. So those are two ways to fix your startup apps. I'll show you that this is macOS High Sierra version 10.13.1 on this so-called unsupported MacBook Pro from mid-2009. You can check out the specs and then compare them with the non-Pro MacBook from also 2009. I think it's late 2009, but same kind of processor, same kind of memory, same video card, and that computer is officially supported. On this computer, I have a 240GB solid state drive, which is why it's usable. Well, I don't want to exaggerate, but I think this computer would be a lot slower if it didn't have an SSD. It's already not very fast because of the relatively old processor, but for basic tasks it works perfectly. I'm not gonna talk about this computer because I already did in another video. But since installing the SSD in August 2016, I think, I've never done another clean installation of the operating system. I've upgraded to Sierra and now High Sierra, and this is how it performs. I don't have too many applications installed, but I do have some. And basically these days I just use it for web browsing, email, managing my iOS devices, browsing some other stuff using Chrome, Twitter, Shazam just in case, notes with OneNote. I don't use these anymore, but I still have them just in case. Plain text editors, writing documents in LaTeX, even though I don't know much about it, I'm trying to learn. And also I use Microsoft Office applications and that kind of stuff. This computer works just fine for those things. I also got a new battery, as I explained in my longer video about this computer, which is low now, so I should plug it in. And this battery is not as good as an original one, but it lasted about 4 hours when it was new, and it still does now, so at least it's consistent. And although macOS Sierra got rid of the estimated time remaining, now it's the estimated time remaining for charging, but when it's running on battery power, it should show how much battery life is left. And macOS Sierra got rid of that, but with an app called Battery Monitor, I was able to see this information again, and I can also see it on the status bar. And as you can see, it's just over 1 year and it has 209 cycles. If this had been my main computer, it would have a lot more cycles than now. But so far with those cycles, it's still about the same as when it was new. So no complaints there. One unfortunate thing that happened to me is the right speaker kind of blew up. So if we try playing a song here, it rattles because one of the speakers is partially blown up, which kind of sucks, but I could take the computer apart and replace the speaker, but it's not worth the trouble for me. We can try out Siri, which, as you can see, has a different icon on High Sierra. And I enabled the Type to Siri thing, so we can write without actually speaking to it. Alessandro. And you can probably hear the rattling speakers. Let's turn off the type thing so we can actually speak to it. It's an accessibility. You can also do this on iOS devices running iOS 11. How much memory do I have?
Your Mac has 8 GB 1067 MHz DDR3 memory.
How fast is my Mac?
Your Mac has a 2.53 GHz Intel Core 2 Duo processor.
What operating system do I have?
Sorry, Alessandro, I can't do that.
You can ask it, but I don't remember the exact question. What macOS version do I have?
Your Mac has macOS 10.1.3.1.17b48 installed.
How much free space do I have?
You have 11.99 gigabytes storage available.
I would have more if I hadn't had that bootcamp partition with Windows. I made that secondary partition 32 gigabytes. But as you can see, Siri works. What model Mac do I have?
Sorry, I can't help you with that here. Sorry, I can't help you with that.
General use is just fine, especially with the solid state drive. If you have a mechanical hard drive, it can still do the same things. It's just gonna be a lot slower. You can try playing a 1080p video. In fact, I'm gonna try editing this video, which is 1080p 60 frames per second, with this computer. So, would I recommend upgrading to macOS High Sierra or even just Sierra on this unsupported computer? To be honest, I don't really need it. The only reason I did was because I could. In fact, I was thinking of downgrading to El Capitan just to have a computer that would work fine in a fully supported way. I need some new applications like the latest version of iTunes, even though I use a special version. 12.6.3 instead of the latest one, which is 12.7, which fully supports newer devices like the iPhone 8 and the iPhone 10 running iOS 11, but it doesn't remove the ability to sync applications and ringtones, a feature which was removed in iTunes 12.7, which you do need to install if you have an iPhone 8 or iPhone 10. But if you want to keep that ability, you can install this iTunes 12 point. To be honest, if you want to try something new, you could install the new macOS versions like Sierra or High Sierra. Oh, and by the way, I haven't converted the drive to APFS, the new Apple file system. I know it can be done, but it does some kind of weird workaround, which actually makes the computer startup slower, so I didn't think it was worth the trouble, but there is an option to do that. Although I don't think you can upgrade, maybe you can convert the file system to APFS in an unsupported way. You can in a supported way, but I don't know in an unsupported way. I didn't really want to mess with it, so I kept the traditional HFS plus file system. It works well enough for me, and I still have trim support enabled, which is important. If there's anything that doesn't work on macOS El Capitan, then I guess you could upgrade. But if you want a stable computer, even though this is pretty stable, I think it's a better idea to stick with the fully supported El Capitan macOS version. When I can do a full backup of this computer, I will probably downgrade it to El Capitan. But for now, with High Sierra, it works just fine, and it hasn't stopped me from doing anything. When I had Sierra, it crashed once while I was using a Linux virtual machine in VirtualBox. But otherwise, it hasn't had any major problems. And by crash, I mean actually it restarted by itself because it had a kernel panic. Anyway, that's it. As always, if I forget to say something, I will add it in the video description, so be sure to read it. If you have any questions, ask in a comment. And thank you for watching.